Hello, everyone. Welcome to the very first Mace Revival on YouTube Live. So this is the first time I've ever put this up here. Thank you for subscribing. How do I know that you subscribed? Because I put it behind a subscribing wall. I'm so happy you're here. Yeah, so everybody just get comfortable. Make sure your water's close by if you're into that sort of thing, hydration. I may have to adjust some camera angles, but right now it looks okay. And I'm doing this because I had several students call out this week, and we still have Mace to rejoice in. So, yeah, thanks for joining, everyone. Check it out. The equipment you need is your body, and I am using, for the first time ever, with tape on it, an Onnit 10-pound mace. Now, if you don't have a mace at home, you could get any long lever or stick that has an offset load. If you don't have that, like sledgehammer, brooms, you could use a stick. You won't have the offset load, but you can apply force, and we're going to talk about that today. So yeah, something that can hold a little bit of force. So a wood stick, metal stick, metal rod, anything like that, or a mace, sledgehammer. Yeah, cool. So we're going to be getting into some open chain mobility to kick things off. Open chain mobility is a level one concept. We're going to talk a lot about level one today. If you want to learn more about level one, if you want to see some of the options, if you like the things that are taught in this class today, head on over to steelmaceflow.com, where you can find the certifications like level one. And I think they just put it on discount, so well worth your time and money. We're going to talk a lot about level one today, and how much I favor and enjoy that course and process. So it's a really good training program. It's a really good system of movement, and go on over there. They've got a lot of cool packages and more after that. If you fall in love, which I did. All right. So let's kick this thing off, y'all. I wanted to boil it down today. Okay. I don't know who's going to be joining on after. We have some advanced students in Mace Revival. And we have some, you know, folks that have been with Mace for a little bit of time and some really brand new beginners. So I like to teach to everyone. We all need this. And we all start at the same place, rock bottom. So I don't expect you, one second guys, I just gotta plug this computer in. I don't expect y'all to follow along with me. If you're a little more advanced in your practice, you can elaborate. Okay, we're going to do some timed sets in here. By all means, if you feel like you want to move along with me and stay with me and just experience it as I go through this, follow along, you know. So we're going to really boil things down today in a very simple and basic way. And after we do that, you'll see as it spider webs out. And there's going to be a lot of opportunity for advanced movements to take off out of that. So, you know, it's programmed for everyone. I hope you enjoy. You don't need your mace for this first part. Let's go grab what is called our standing structure.
All right. So the very first thing we want to do before we pick up our mace is mobilize our body and get ourselves ready to move, okay?
One second, y'all. I just got to tip this a little more. I want y'all to see my feet. There we go. I believe I can fly.
There we go. Cool. So the standing structure is a way that we stand to prioritize the strength and length of our spine. All right. So we want those feet straight forward. All right. And those knees we call soft knees, having a slight bend in the knees. And that allows our hip girdle to get tucked underneath us, squeezing through the glutes. And we can get tall in the air and squeeze down to the midsection. All right. Very nice. And you can rip that floor apart through the feet. What that means is we're adding anti-rotation, and that keeps these hips nice and strong while their upper body can mobilize and really prioritizes the strength in the low spine, right? And the straightness of the low spine. So once again, feet straight forward, soft knees, play with that hip, rotate that under you, squeeze into the glutes, reach through the spine, pack that core in, and last but not least, roll those shoulders down and back. Big open heart there. Good work, y'all. All right. So the first thing we're going to do is rock this hip forward and backwards. So back and forth there. All right. I'm trying to keep that separate from the rest of my spine. All right. From the side, it's going to do something like this. Seconds. Very nice, y'all. All right, as we bring that spine nice and tall once again, let's check in through this whole section here, keeping those knees soft. You're still ripping apart on the floor there a bit. All right, we have those glutes squeezing. And we're nice and straight in that little spine again. We're just loosening it up here, trying to keep the spine nice and straight as we dip into some lateral sits. Left and right. And if your hips are tight this morning, which mine are a bit tight, you can exhale. Really engage into that extension through there. Very nice. Keep going. If you've been hitting it hard to just one angle, you can vary the angle. Maybe kick it back at like 45. Doing the best to keep that spine. You can hinge it. Nice. Angle. Ooh, that's treating you right. There we go. Good stuff, y'all. All right, coming nice and tall. Let's pick a direction, either one, and hinge. And we're going to get into all four cardinal directions now, combining those first two movements into some hip circles. Go as slow as you need. Go as fast as you want. Some days I just need to really own the edges before I start digging into those corners. So feel free to be kind to yourself and give yourself what you need there. We're still focusing on keeping the spine nice and long through here. Nice. All right, if you want to grab your standing structure once again or just switch rotations, you can go from there. We're going to switch sides. This is a great mobility routine, this open chain mobility, okay? This is a level one concept. If you do this every single day of your life, at least 10, 20 minutes, go through these movements, your body's going to thank you for it. I mean, it really is injury prevention and
absolutely necessary
for longevity if you're gonna move your mace. Very nice, y'all. Last rotation there. As you come back with your standing structure, I'm gonna shake it out, move those legs around. We're gonna talk a lot about anti-rotation today. If it gets a little stuck in the legs through this, just shake your legs around before you do the next drill. All right, so let's lock that standing structure right back up, y'all. Feet straight forward, knees are soft, the hips back underneath us, okay? Tall in the crown of the head, chin back, crush that midsection in, still getting tall there and rolling our shoulders down and back. Now, with that big open heart, you can touch in with the shoulders, whatever you wanna do there. And we're gonna slide the spine left and right. In order to be able to do that, keep those hips strong, we need to really rip the feet apart across the floor. Okay. It's a tricky concept at first. It was for me. Just play with it. And if you're having trouble, vary the depth of your knees or check in with your hips. You can vary that. It's different for each person. Going left to right. 5 more seconds. Very nice. All right, coming back to our standing structure. We're gonna go with a little north-south movement back and forth. We're gonna bring some big breath along, all right? I like to tune up the breath a lot. It really focuses a good mind-body connection. Well, hand gets us super hyped. All right, so set that standing structure in. All right, lock up the core. All right, we're gonna be articulating our mid-spine and our C-spine. I want everyone's low spine to be nice and strong, glute strong, okay? We're strong through the front of the hip, diamonds in our heart. All right, we're gonna breathe in through the belly, squeezing into the chest and into the head, and opening, and then rounding, exhaling and forward. Find your flow through here. 9 more. Back and forth. You can stick with me or find your own pace. Halfway there. Let's challenge the breathing. And 3 more. Last 2. And 1. Breathe in. Get super tall. And just shake everything out. Move through your body. Get all that unstuck trauma out of there. It's good stuff. Good work, y'all. All right, now we're gonna, same thing as we did with the low hips. We're gonna combine all 2 movements into 4 quadrants and circle the spine, okay? So to do so, we really need a firm grasp on this anti-rotation on the floor, okay? So knees soft, feet are straight forward, hips are back under us, squeeze into the glutes and really activate on that floor, okay? I want you guys to really challenge through here. And what we're gonna do is just try to combine all those angles into a circle. And slow and small is fine. I mean, sometimes I'm really challenged with this drill, so I might just start very close to center and go through there. All right, let's go 10 more seconds here. Try to get tall through the rest of that spine. Nice, let's switch directions. Was our low spine. We just did our mid spine. Now we're going to go up to our C spine. All right. So locking those feet up. All right. The whole standing structure is the same. Cue it up on your own now. All right. I want everyone, as we go through this movement today, be your own coach. All right. For time's sake, I'm going to start dropping some of the standing structure cues off. I want you to check in with your hips occasionally, check in with your knees. Okay. Hey, what are my feet doing? What do they look like right now? Something feels wonky. Check it out. Okay. Here we go, y'all. So lock that standing structure up, roll the shoulders back and push those palms forward and just a little bit into the earth there, all right? If you get the tinglies, just take it a little easier, all right? So tall spine, and we're gonna start with just some very gentle head tilts here, moving from the crown of the head, the very top. Bodies are strong, our necks are free. I'm pretty activated through the center line. Very good. As everybody finds neutral once again, and adjusting anything you need to, taking that head left and right. I'm trying to up that range of motion to the left and to the right. Very nice. All right, and heads back at neutral. This is a fun one. All right, let's reaffirm our lock on the floor. Let's reaffirm our shoulders and through our center line activation. Crown of the head is tall, and we're going to go chin forward, chin back, forward and back. Very nice. Last one. And as you find neutral once again. And this one's super fun and challenging, so take it easy. Try to find it. We're going to get tall through the crown. And it's like we're sliding our ear to the opposite shoulder. Okay, keeping that shoulder line down, and you can do that pressing through the hands. And it doesn't take much, especially if you're not used to it. Or if your neck's stiff. It's a sweet spot. Good. All right, let's see if we can combine those movements. Pick a direction. Slow, flat circles. Nice. And you can switch directions on your own there.
They're fresh from the farm, and they all
want to be. Keep going, y'all. All right, last location. And shake it out when you're done. Good job, y'all. All right, so that was the spinal mobility, all right, from level one. If you notice, we hit the low spine, then the mid spine, then the C spine. Took care of that pretty rudimentary, right, laterally and forward and back, and then added rotation. All right, so now we're going to move on to the extremities. All right, I like to just do these little short circles. They're really fun, and they're meant for everyone. So feet straight forward, lock up that standing structure just like you would. We're really going to need it now because we're going to be balancing on one leg, and I want you all to have a really nice tall front hip, your glutes flexed. Let's not lock these knees out. Let's keep them soft. And we're going to scoop a leg up, keeping that toe flexed, high to the sky, and inside circles, okay? We're working on balance. We're working on opening our foot up on the post side and just doing these little tiny circles. If you lose balance, you can just kind of kickstand in there and then pick it right back up. Nice. And let's extend the toes and feet, pressing through the front side of that leg and open the circles outward. We're just getting those hips juicy, you know what I mean? All right. Opening that leg all the way up and through and setting it down back where we would have our post in the standing structure. Everybody can check in with their standing structure real quick. All right, nice hard center line, opposite side. Toe flexed high, inside circles. Very nice, yeah. And press and extend those toes and feet, outside circles. All right, open those hips through the range of motion and set it back down. We're going to do the same exact thing, y'all, to the side. All right, so that was forward and checking with that standing structure. Open the hip to the side and we're going to flex those toes up inside circles again. Nice. Let's point those toes outside circles. Very nice. Opening that hip one last time and a little toe pivot into our standing structure, opposite side. Nice. And let's point those toes. Pointy toes, technical term, outside circles. Good. Opening those hips up. Good job, y'all. Shake those legs out a little bit. All right. Really basic drill for the knees here. All right. We're going to hold our standing structure strong. We're going to be balancing once again. Scoop whatever leg you want to start. I'm on my right. And we're just going to slowly control some circular movements with that foot and knee. Trying to keep that leg on a 90. Two 90s, one off the hip, one off that knee. I guess just the hip, right? Yeah. The knee is rotating various degrees. Good job, y'all. You can open the other direction. And setting it down. All right. Every time checking in with that structure, just like we're about to swing, and bringing that opposite leg up. Inside circles. Kind of let that feet, that feet, let your feet do whatever they want to do. And then let's open to the other direction. This is a nice low stress one for when your knees are a little beat up. Good job. All right, setting that down, back into our standing structure. Good job, y'all. You've hung with me this far. I love open chain mobility. It makes me feel good. It is a practice of diligence and discipline, though, and it repays you in the end. So let's lock up our standing structure once more. We got a couple more to go with the upper half. Let's just grab light bulbs out here, okay, keeping our shoulders down with those lat activations. All right, we're just doing shoulder screws. Nice tall spine. Really squeezing through that lower abdomen. Squeezing glutes. Ooh, yeah. Mm-hmm. If your shoulders are feeling good, all loosey-goosey like, you can start getting the Shaolin pack going. Whoa, okay, really pulling through that lat. activating a little bit of a counter rotation to that closing arm. Would that be opening? That's opening. All right. A couple more. Get those shoulders. Get those forearms feeling good. All right. Shake it out. These are called elbow drivers, y'all, and they're my favorite. So lock that standing structure up. It really matters. Let's keep a nice hard center line. Okay, a lot of flexion in here. A lot of activation. All right, good tight glute. Activate on the floor a little bit through your anti-rotation. And we're going to grab whatever arm you want to start with behind the head. And we're literally creating a hard center and taking this elbow and driving it through the front plane across of our face. Checking in with our center line as a little tactile cue there. Am I activated and driving the opposite one? We can get high reaches here. All right. Start slow and small, just like you would with anything else. And just check those shoulders now. And as they warm into this, we can put a little more intensity, pushing the elbow and driving it across. And you are learning 360 swing mechanics right here. A lot of swing mechanics based on the shoulder. So we ain't gonna do that today. You can pick any speed you want. You can rock the hips. Just keep tall through the low spine. Okay, by activating the glutes, the butt muscles. Your butt. Keep going through there. Keep going. 40 seconds. You want the shoulders to heat up. Stuff. Move your wrists around, roll them around, maybe hit a gable grip, do that, press a block out, pull the shoulders back, tighten that abdomen, maybe paint the fence, a couple seconds, just get it going. Good work, y'all. Oh, that is our open one. That is our open chain, level one mobility. Cool. All right. How's everyone feel? I always feel like a lot of money better. I was going to say like $1 million better, but no, it's probably more than that. Cool. So I'm going to go over some basic 360 cues and mechanics here. For those of you who this is might be foreign to, or if it's new to you, you just need a little cleanup. Today's all about the basics. So we're really going to be cueing in from a basic degree, and how you want to treat that from there and progress onward is up to you. Okay. I know there's people with some advanced practices out there. So, you know, by all means, when we get into these working sets, elaborate. All right. Let the mace serve you. So, I'm just going to go over my mace real quick. This is the first time I taped it. All right. So a couple visual cues here. That's the cap. All right. It's taped right at the end of the cap. This one, the mid fulcrum, I call it. That's a just inside the knurling. Okay. At the very top knurling. All right. You notice on an Onnit mace, and a lot of maces, you'll have two knurling patterns. Okay. Bottom and a mid staff or whatever. So that's just inside, okay, the knurling. So it's actually covering some of the knurling. And then this one is on the globe. In Steel Mace Flow, in our language set, we call this the globe,
All right. You'll also hear it called the bell, many other things in other language sets. Okay. So 360 swing mechanics. All right. A 360 swing is anytime we rotate this mace around our body in a 360 degree fashion. It could be anywhere on the mace. Okay. So if this is a first time, or if it's foreign to us, or we're still working on our basic reps, just grabbing that mace in what is called warrior stance, and you can choke up. All right. So, and you can hold that anywhere you'd like. I would be on my feet, and we are going to be on our feet for this purpose. I'm going to demonstrate on my knees. Okay. You can still swing on your knees too. Just create your standing structure on your knees. All right. So from warrior stance, there's four landmarks in a 360 swing. All right. Top hand points the direction of travel, and we go into the block. All right. Let's get those blocks about crown of the head height. All right. Like they could actually block something coming inward and inbound to our head. And we're going to comb those hands back as we push the mace into our dump. All right. A lot of flexion through the center line as that mace tries to pull us backwards. And we're going to wink that opposite elbow and elbow drive it through the dump into the pole. All right. And then landing in warrior stance. Okay. Warrior stance, block, dump, pull. All right. Some really basic cues here. All right. Let's make sure that our glutes are always activated and that this low spine is as straight or as strong as that can be. Okay. Based on what's going on with you. Your knees are soft. Let's check out those knees and feet from time to time. Okay. Anywhere from straightforward to slightly canted, I think is optimal, based on, you know, what's going on in people's bodies. And, with the upper half, it really matters. Okay. Lots of tension through the core at all times. Okay. And, when we go and through these landmarks, try to have a tight elbow position around that skull. And you can play with your wrists, all right, to see what degree your elbows favor. All right, we're going to get into a 5-minute 360 swing set. Thanks for hanging in there, y'all, through that little 360 swing cue up. Any 360 swings you'd like, all right, I'm going to put on some tunes. And, yeah, 360, 10 and 2, alternating. I'm going to go through and demonstrate a bunch of them. So, and I'll sound them off when I do, all right? If you want to stick with me, go ahead. If you want to do your own thing, fucking rock and roll. Here we go. All right. So let's grab that standing structure, y'all. Feet straight forward. Soft knees. The hips are underneath you. Squeezing through the glutes, flex those core, reach through the crown of the head with that mace and warrior stance. One second, y'all. Get around this conversion, you know what I'm saying? I'm always trying to sell you stuff. I mean, I'll try to sell you through this class. Let's get a nice little level one. Here we go, y'all. 5 minutes to swing. Let's open these shoulders up. Lots of anti-rotation on my floor. Thank you.
lot of elbow drive. There you go. Check in with the feet. Check in with the knees. What are your hips doing? Good workout. Squeeze those cores. You can do as many left or right as you'd like. You can even go one to one. Create a little float. Cross body, bottom, back. How did that feel?
Oh man, I feel like it opened my shoulders immensely.
Nothing like a good 360 swing. I love 360s. Such a dichotomous move, the 360 swing. When you watch it, so simple. A lot of things going on, isn't there? Internally. Externally, all of it. So thanks for allowing me to share that, y'all. Cue up those 360 swings from a real basic degree. Hope you enjoyed that 5 minutes. Cool, now that we're warmed up, our breathing's a little more open. We have got a good grasp of our structure, where that's at today, and our shoulders are warm. Let's get into, I wanted to do a little level one talk real quick, all right? For those of you out there, I don't think this is working anymore. Nor do I need it. 1 second. Yeah, I think that can go over here. Let me just check, make sure everybody can hear me. Check, 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 check. Cool. I think you can hear me. All right, so, yeah, level one, steel mace flow. Just gotta turn this down. So, I first picked up a mace in 2016, and I started moving the mace, like, disciplined, the summer of 2017. So, this summer, it will be my five-year anniversary from the moment I knew that I was gonna be committed to this thing. And ever since, I've been studying Steel Mace Flow Level 1 very diligently. And it is my perspective that Level 1 is a masterpiece. And I'm going to explain why, all right? I believe it was communicated from God through Leo Savage, if you all aren't aware of who he is. He was my teacher, and he has a YouTube channel, so head on over there. I believe it is Leo Savage, so just hit some subscribes on him and check him out. He is a wealth of knowledge and such an incredible resource, as his YouTube channel has been going for years on the mace, so it is an excellent resource, as well as steelmaceflow.com, so check that out as well. Yeah, Leo pulled level one out of the ether, and you know, there are things in life that you just recognize their beauty through truth and their simplicity. And I believe level one falls under that category, because when you experience the mace for enough time, you realize that the masterpiece of what level one is in its simplicity, and that everything in level two and everything outside of that really has a root in level one. Okay. And I hope to show some of that today. Yeah. So it's just an utter masterpiece through its truth and simplicity alone. And I like to just compare it to some of the most beautiful things in life that are simple. You know, Einstein was a firm believer that, you know, science really wasn't going to come full circle until it started simplifying itself and explaining the world around us, which oftentimes science tends to lack. So you'll find in true masterpieces that oftentimes they're based or even boiled down to the most simplistic version. So, you know, if you only studied level one and became proficient at it, eventually, hopefully mastering it, not saying that you're ever going to get there, but, you know, the course is worth the journey. So if you just studied level one, you would be capable of so much beautiful, seamless, poetic movement, and I really believe that's the power of it. Not to mention it's super hard, so it is a hard course. There's lots of reps. It'll get you jacked and open your body up, and there's a whole lot more surprises than that. I'll tell you what, that's just the physiology and the physical effects and beauty of it. So let's get into this, y'all. So that's my little level one rant. Such a powerful course, and a powerful, it's really a powerful game changer, man. So, if y'all haven't checked that out, maybe think about it, right? What we're going to do now is talk about, like, how boiled down we can get it. All right. Let's tell you a little bit about me. Is, you know, I, talking about dichotomy earlier in this talk, I am a dichotomous man. I like to push the envelope to both opposite ends of the spectrum, whatever that spectrum may be usually. and I come out somewhere on the other side. I don't spend a whole lot of time in moderation, although I am starting to learn that through wisdom, I believe. So a lot of times in my mace movement, I push the boundaries, right? I get really outside or on the edge of what I am capable of. You do that enough and you start to realize like, okay, we need to rein it back in. We're being a little chaotic and you need some order in your life. And that's where simplicity comes in. And that's where the basics come in. And as my background as a martial artist, I know that, you know, the basics form the foundation of the house, the foundation of the pyramid, wherever you're living. Okay. And you want a strong foundation, right? So it's super important to study the basics. And today we're going to get into presses and rows and talking about those. Anyone who's come from like a barbell or a workout background will recognize a lot of this movement. All right. As we start this, I want to talk about grips. All right. Simple way we translate grips to each other is globe end first, over. And that would be like a barbell grip, right? That we would use to press something, right? Or a deadlift possibly in that. Some people deadlift in this grip. Okay, so if we're communicating this side first, it would be over, under, okay? And we can switch that to an under, okay? Under, under, there's over, over, there's under, over. This is super common. So yeah, just remember, whatever I communicate first is closest to the globe. And then the tail end comes in after that. Okay. There's a lot of other types of grips, but in presses and rows, we'll be staying predominantly in a two-handed grip on this mace. All right. So we're going to explore this presses and rows. As we do this, if you don't have an understanding of landmarks, you're going to get that as well. This is going to be a 4-minute set. All right. If you're just starting out in this, please stick with me. If you can, just try to go through it and have fun. If you've been doing this for a while, rock and roll, you know what I'm saying? All right, here we go, y'all. Let's grab that standing structure, okay? I want everyone in an over-over grip, wherever they'd like on their mace, okay? If you can use the whole mace, you could shorten the grip, whatever's right for you right now, and I advocate you to experiment. Here we go. 4 minutes. All right, we're checking that standing structure out. Feet straight forward. Knees are soft. Hips are underneath us. Let's just hold it here. Okay. Everybody check in with their anti-rotation. I want everybody to challenge their anti-rotation through these 4 minutes, all right? Squeezing the structure, squeezing the spine, checking those cues, all right? And I'm at a little angle today, but you'll notice this one right here is landmark two, okay? This is it's basically a guide point to our movement, all right? Anytime we're here, landmark two, okay? Landmark two, rotated. Landmark two, front. Landmark two. Landmark two, over. All right, we're back in over. All right, and everybody just push those elbows forward, and let's come to a landmark three. All right, so you notice we went up a number, and we went up in the air. All right, so it goes 1, 2, 3, 4. And from here, we're going to just start with our first press today. All right, and before we do, let's explain anti-rotation. I want to give you a coach's challenge, all right? I want everybody to crush or rip the fuck out of your mace as we go through this presses and rows today, all right? So right here, if I wanted to press this into landmark four, I could crush that mace, holding that center line nice and strong. And when I get all the way up there, I can rip it back down. And what we're looking for is to keep that line nice and true, all right? Keeping the offset load even in the visual space, which is harder than it looks. All right, one more time, let's press it from landmark three all the way up to landmark four and down. Good stuff. For symmetry's sake, let's do the same thing on the other side. We're gonna get into a sword draw switch. Thumb down, flex those side bodies down and pull that mace out of there. All right, here we go, landmark three, pressing it, crushing it, up to landmark four. You can rip it too, whatever you like. Sticking with conventional movement right now. Nice, and back down. Very good, y'all. All right, let's crush it back to landmark two. All right, so now we're gonna go over a little bent over row. All right, I'm gonna turn on a profile for y'all, and I'm gonna keep this nice and tight, communicating in with my body.
I'm going to hit a hinge, keeping those knees soft, my spine super straight, all right, and squeezing the core, and we're going to press it out of there and row it up. And again. Nice. And let's hit that hinge. Good. And let's hit that same sword draw switch to the other side. Literally never catch that ever. Here we go. Hinge. When it's in landmark two. And we're going to press it down. And we're going to row it up. Nice. Good job, y'all. All right. Know that we can press and row on all sides of our bodies, okay? Maybe not all sides. You can't do it to the rear. All right. So let's sword draw switch back to landmark three. All right. This is a press called a front extended crush press. We rotate those elbows to the rear, strong center line, and we press it out to an extended landmark three. And we can crush, rip, snap it in, whatever we want. Elbows back underneath us and switch. Here we go. Same thing, opposite side. There. Crushing it out. Ripping it in. Here we go. Coach, does that work in step? It sure does. Let's try it. All right. So from our standing structure, let's take a step one. That's a forward lunge on that globe side. All right. From there, we're going to rotate. That's counter rotation. And front extended, side extended, crush press, and rip, and down, good, opposite side, sword draw switch, landmark three on the side, step, side extended, crush press, very nice, y'all. All right. Time. Good job. If that didn't light your forearms up and really challenge your structure, gotta rip harder. All right, good job, y'all. That was fun. So let's just go through this now, all right? My whole intention here is to show you exactly what I talked about in the level one talk. In that there are some fun things that can come from presses and rows, right? I mean, so often I get so far out on these boundaries of mace exploration, movement exploration, mind you, whatever that is for me on this given day. And I'm like, man, I'm just searching for more ideas, you know, like I'm kind of stuck, I've plateaued, right? Well, boil it down. And that's something I'll go to often is like, boil it down. Presses and rows, start there. If maybe the move that you were exploring has a lineage or a connection to landmark three. Okay, let's explore it. All right. Say I was in a landmark three. And by all means, this is a follow along. So if you all want to follow along with me, go ahead. If there's a move I hit that you cannot hit, don't worry. No worries. Just catalog it. And you can ask me questions about it later or, you know, this stuff is formed and based in thousands and tens of thousands of reps. So take your time with this stuff. Feel free to explore. Be mindful. All right. So from a landmark three, okay, I can press that up into the sky. Okay. And I'm just in a press here, aren't I? Right. But like any time that I'm here or here, I can drop that behind my head, couldn't I? And just feed that into a one-arm swing, right? So we just took a press and a row and turned it into a one-arm, right? I could cast that to the other side of my head too and hit that same one-arm, okay? It doesn't have to be as technical as that, really. I mean, if we took this from a landmark three, okay? I know we didn't hit the ballistic or switch curl today, but if we just open this channel here, keeping that thumb out of the way, we can slide that right back into a different grip, an under-over grip, where we came from, an over-over grip, okay? Back to an under-over grip. And that's straight from landmarks, okay? That's, I mean, we could have literally hit some sort of a press, all right, some sort of a row, maybe an A-frame elevator, you know what I'm saying? And switch. Okay, so we can apply quick transitions out of the presses and rows as well. All right, let's see what else we can link presses and rows with. I like, if we were in an over-over grip, literally anywhere from landmark one, landmark two, landmark three, and we have to make a modification for landmark four, but they're all applicable into a Kimura grip. All right, and those of you with jiu-jitsu or catch wrestling or any kind of grappling background, you'll notice that this is a figure four with the arms, a Kimura. Okay, I have the same side of the globe, okay, controlling the globe. The opposite arm comes in around the mace in through the center and retrieves the wrist, okay? And that's a whole nother exploration through there. All right, you experience that. Kimura grip, okay? So I know we're starting to elaborate, okay, and starting to push that movement outside of the boundaries of level one now. But let's take it back. Let's take it back to level one and talk about a concept that I just demonstrated. All right. The concept is we were in landmark three. Okay. If I decided to swing this mace from here, I'm swinging it, if you want to call it the mace proper or the way, you know, I guess stereotypically you hold a mace, right? Now, from that same position, we also have the opportunity to come in and now control the mace from the globe. Okay, so the real benefit to presses and rows and owning a landmark is it might seem super simple and it might be like, ah, well, you know, I'm too advanced for that now. You can link it to some very advanced moves and also alternating how you hold this mace. Presses and rows. Look, there is a globe end movement called the outside sword swing. If I pull it back into another landmark, another press, another row, I could jump right into a swing from the opposite end. Okay, so presses and rows, landmarks, have this really cool ability to transition ends of the mace in a very controlled fashion without throwing your mace through the air, which is also another method. And there ain't nothing wrong with that either. So, yeah, just be careful. So I think that's one of the coolest things about presses as a rose is you can take something very simple and you can link it to literally everything. I mean, from that press and row, we can also turn it vertical or put it on another trajectory and turn it into a shield. All right. I demonstrated one sword swing, but literally when you have this mace from any position, you can start going through all sorts of sword swings, okay? If I had it an under over, right, I could start elaborating sword swings from a sword up position, all right? Press. You see, the advanced movements have a home and an origin in the root movements, okay? And if anything, I believe the level one movements, the root movements, the core movements, they are designed to give you the functionality, the strength, the connectedness to your mace, to the floor, to the earth, whatever you're flowing on. It's designed to give you a proper structure, a proper balance, proper feel with the mace. You'll notice in level one, there's not a single time, except for the one arm swing, that two hands come off the mace. Okay, the one arm swing is the only time, I believe,
the savage pickup as well. Okay, that both hands are not on the mace. Okay, and what that means is, whenever we have both hands on the mace, both feet on the ground, we have the easiest way to apply anti-rotation and control and or stop our own rotation. Okay, and that's essential because we're purposely rotating a weight, okay, around our structure. All right, so anytime we have two hands on this, 2 feet on the floor, we can apply moderate anti-rotation, maximum anti-rotation, whatever the move calls for, whatever the scene calls for, whatever the feeling calls for, okay, to be safe. But in a training aspect, it really provides that structural strength, okay, over hundreds and literally thousands of reps in level one, okay, not hundreds of thousands, but thousands, okay. Yeah, it provides that structure, it provides that mobility. You know, we might not be able to fully lock out an arrow at first, right? But through enough reps and proper movement there, we can start to get our arrow on point. Okay, and then when it comes time to do advanced movements in that pattern, we can be strong, okay, in those, and have a finer understanding of the basics. Does that make sense? Yeah. So it's important to learn the basics, important to learn the functionality and do the hard work first, because it really will keep you safe, like free, and well, it'll really blossom your level two or your more advanced mace work, because you have an understanding of where this stuff comes from. All right. Yeah, that's my rant on activation, anti-rotation, and the basics of level one and how it blossoms, you know, advanced movements. You know, I can't start whipping a sword swing around. Well, I can, because I did it. I wouldn't advise it, but whipping a sword swing around my body at 110% velocity, when you don't know where you can stop that thing in a safe space, in a landmark, somewhere where you're not going to tweak your shoulder or, you know, smoke your shin or drop your globe directly onto your kneecap. So, you know, like, that's important to know the foundational roots for that. Cool. Last little movement, y'all. Thanks for hanging with me this long. I just want to get outside the box a little bit towards the end, and we're going to explore a level two concept. But you're going to see how it plugs right in with level one still. All right. And we're still going to be in the same landmarks that we've been doing the whole time. All right. So this next concept is called shield arm. This is a really cool concept. If you've already worked a lot with the mace, this is going to give you a lot of cool opportunities. We're going to study today. I like to call it shield arm outside. Okay. So what we're going to do is the same thing. We translate the grip with the globe. We're going to translate our shield arm with the globe as well. So this would be outside shield arm, okay? Inside shield arm being the globe towards the heart or towards the center line, okay? So that is shield arm. Let's play with it. All right, let's learn it together. And then I'm going to give us a little four or five minute working set on exploration in that movement and linking it with the things that you already know. And if this is your first time or you're really new at this stuff, just link it to things you want to do. Okay, do cool stuff with the mace, do what you want. That's what's important. It really is. Okay, your body knows how to move, you just got to give it permission to be free. Here we go. So I'm in my standing structure on my knees. All right, that way I can get close to the camera here, y'all. And shield arm. All right, you'll notice we start in warrior stance, level one move. All right, if I wanted to swing this mace around my body in a 360 swing fashion, I literally could take that bottom arm, pulling down on the lat, activating, driving that elbow down. The lat activation is super important in shield arm to keep those shoulders safe. Bring that arm across the clavicle line, AKA landmark three, and we could touch the shaft in on our wrist and lay it into landmark three. okay? This is shield arm, and it is landmark 3. Do you see? It's pretty cool, right? Landmark 3 turns into shield arm with one arm, okay? And all sorts of things progress out of that, right? We could roll it back off that into a warrior stance. And we could just literally create a fun little, I call them flow katas through there. Boom, 360 swing into a shield arm. Control your shield arm. Maybe you hit a step. Boom. Grab that mace. Glide it up. 360 swing. Shield arm. Okay? And you could go back and forth through there. Back up. 360 swing. Just each time experiencing that, getting tighter, tuning back in with your structural cues. How's my breath? How's my elbow drive? Can I communicate with that mace better? All right, good work. Shield arm goes into so many things, all right? So we're in landmark 3 right there, okay? We caught it from a 360 swing or from a warrior stance, okay? But it also links to a lot of other fun basic moves from level 1. If I were to just come across and touch in with that mace, thumb up right near the globe, we could pull that across our center line, cross body top, landmark 2, cross body bottom, and we're in a switch curl. Okay? Shield up. Switch curl. Shield on. All right, super cool. The fact that it links so easily with a move like switch curl or the 360 swing, probably two of the most common, absolute common moves in Steel Mace Flow. It's going to open up a lot of your world. I mean, there's so much out of here, y'all. We can bottom swing, back up to our 360 swing, shield arm. I don't know if I can hit it right now. I've hit a scabbard through here, but this would be a challenge on the knees right now. Yeah, so let's have fun with this, y'all. All right, we're going to do 4 minutes. The last 4 minutes of the day. All right, I'm just going to kind of go through some free flow and link shield arm to a few things. If you see something you like, you can save the question for later. Enjoy. All right, link it to your landmarks. Have fun with shield arm. Okay, practice some steps. Once you have it owned in your standing structure or have it a good grasp of in your standing structure, start challenging and adding footwork onto it. Forward lunge, lateral lunge, reverse lunge, cross back step. Okay, here we go, y'all. Last 4 minutes.
Put them gongs back on.
Warrior stance, y'all. Standing structure. All right. If you were to just reverse blood oath, invert the wrist, palm towards the heart, slide it up the mace, control it into a shield arm. Right. Fun way to play with shield arm is just to see if you can keep it stable in your steps. It's a good challenge. Thank you.
water across the front plane right into your outside chakra. Battle strike. Battle stance. Shield. Shield arm. Has a lot of implications for opening out and getting into some flux.
Low bottom
pipe switches. Sword cradle, which is essentially landmark 2 up to landmark 3. Shield arm.
Right on, revivalists. Thanks for hanging out with me today. That was fun. Thank you for allowing me to share the blessings that are level 1. Yeah, it'll strengthen your body. It'll open your mind. It'll open your body up. All right, it'll treat those long-held injuries, and it'll open those up. All right, it'll circulate a lot of that blood around. It's a very healing course. It's a very building course. Thanks for allowing me to go on a couple little dissertations about it and also sharing all this knowledge today. All right, a little knowledge transfer. All right, just a little recap, y'all. We did open chain mobility. That's from level 1. All right, we hit a 360 swing set for 5 minutes. Okay, we covered a few types of swings through that set. Then we talked about level 1, okay? And what we can pull from the basics, from this very beautiful orchestration of how to move the mace with 2 hands and 2 legs and a body and a mind and a heart and a spirit, okay? So we went through that. We enjoyed some presses and rows, talked about all the cool stuff out of there. I think one of the best things out of that lesson today, y'all, is the fact that whenever you have that in a presser row, you can decide which end to take off on. And that's super exciting to me because when I get caught, I know a lot of you all too, in flow loops, you want to change that and you want to experience some more freedom. All right. So thanks for allowing me to share that, y'all. Covered a little shield arm at the end. I hope you have a blessed rest of your Saturday. Enjoying your time with friends, families, loved ones. Thanks so much for letting me share this. Love y'all. Catch you next Saturday.